You're looking at a live shot from NASA astronauts today capturing the SpaceX Dragon ahead of a historic docking expected at the International Space Station later today. This move marks a momentous shift in U.S. space maneuvers. Here to tell us all about it is Andy Pastor. He is in Los Angeles. Andy, tell us, today signifies what kind of a step forward in terms of private space travel?
So what we have here is a really resounding success in terms of the engineering and scientific and operational parts of this. You had a new rocket, a new spacecraft or capsule, and an entirely new system of sensors and thrusters on the capsule in order to get close to the space station and to be able to have a mechanical arm snatch it. So all three of these systems really worked almost perfectly, and many experts, including champions of commercial space and champions of SpaceX, would have said, and in fact did say before the mission, that they thought it was pretty unlikely that all three of these separate systems would work so well. So I would say it's a resounding technical and scientific success. The business aspects of it and what it means for commercial space ventures, that, you know, we can parse in many ways. That's not so clear, certainly.
Now, Andy, once SpaceX Dragon is docked, what will happen next? What will they load into SpaceX, and when will it try to return to Earth?
It's going to return in about a week. They're going to take out the cargo, about 1,000 pounds, 1,200 pounds that they've taken up, which is considered non-crucial cargo, essentially some foodstuffs and clothes and other things for the station. They're going to bring down, not very attractive, basically junk, garbage and other things that they want to dispose of, and some experiments, which they want to put back into the capsule and bring down to Earth, because the capsule has a heat shield and it won't burn up, so therefore the experiments will be safe.
Now, Andy, after NASA's final space shuttle flight last summer, astronauts have had to go, I think, through Russia in order to get up to the space station. In terms of these commercial private space shuttles being able to take astronauts up, when do we expect that may happen?
Well, that's the big question. For example, and it could be, at best, it could be 5 years, probably longer than that if you listen to the experts. This capsule that's now docked at the space station, or will be docked at the space station, is the same one that SpaceX plans and hopes to use to take astronauts up there. So this is a pretty big step for them, because the systems work. They need to do some additional work to protect the astronauts during launch and so on. But I would say that the debate over manned commercial programs taking astronauts to the station, that will continue, but maybe with a little less heat and more light. But we're really looking at least 5 years before U.S. astronauts get on the U.S. spacecraft launched by a U.S. rocket.
Now, many of the cargo ships that have been going up there from other countries, they haven't been bringing back anything really of value. Most of them, I think, burning up in the atmosphere when they come back. When Dragon comes back into the U.S., into the Earth's atmosphere, what are the dangers there, Andy? I mean, any risks, or is it a pretty easy landing?
Well, it's a parachute landing, and really the risks are if the parachute doesn't work, but it's worked previously on the last test flight, which was not to the space station, but just into orbit. The parachute worked very well, and I would say that's certainly a less risky and probably a less complicated part of this mission than launching at a precise instant, which they had to do, and then maneuvering so precisely that a 50-foot robotic arm could grab the capsule while it's in tandem in orbit next to the space station, traveling at 17,000 miles an hour.
Wow. All right. Well, we will all be watching when it comes back, and we will be coming to you too, Andy Pastor. He's been covering space and aeronautics for us for about 15 years. Thanks for being with us, Andy.